So, you're awake. Let's keep this nice and simple. You're going to tell me the code for that purifier, and you're going to tell me now.
What the hell's going on here?
I'll tell you what's going on here. You lost. The good guys won this one, and now we're just wrapping up loose ends. We've got the purifier, now we just need the code to start it. You're going to give me that code now, and save us all a lot of trouble. Maybe I'll even let you go. So how about it?
Fuck you. I'm not telling you anything.
I'll be honest. I'm running out of patience here, and I'm not looking to play games with you. You tell me that code, or it's going to cost you.
No, seriously. Fuck you.
Why do you insist on provoking me? Tell me the code now.
Colonel, I have need of you.
Mr. President, I have no time for other matters. I'll be with you shortly.
Now, Colonel.
Yes, sir.
Ah, alone at last. I do apologize for Colonel Autumn's attitude. He's been under a great deal of stress lately. No doubt that you know who I am. I'm sure you've heard my radio broadcasts. I'd like to have a word with you face to face. I think there are a few things that you and I should discuss. You'll find your possessions in the locker near the door. I'll unlock the way for you. And I'll unlock your restraints as well. I'll be waiting for you in my office. Please don't tarry.
Howdy folks, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Fallout 3. I apologize for the kind of immediate jump into the game there, but I felt it kind of fitting with how the last episode ended. So, you are going to notice immediately here that my hit points probably aren't at the same level, and I'm going to be looking, well, I won't right now. Once I loot all of this, I will be. I will be looking better. I've got more stim packs, and I've got better ammo than I did last time. The reason behind that is I actually played through the previous content a second time, because this area that we are going into is no joke, and I basically couldn't get through it. So I'm hoping that maybe now I will be able to actually have a chance to it. Ideally. Where is Occam's Razor? And where is my shitty sniper? Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is save, and I believe this is episode 43. I'm going to do a hard save, quick save, and pull out a gun. I'm actually going to use, I think, my assault rifle for this.
Hold it right there. You're supposed to be in that holding cell. You're not going anywhere. There's a full complement of guards in the next room. As soon as I get them, you're going back to your cell. In a body bag, if necessary.
Take a hike before you get squashed.
I have somewhere else to be.
Lamest threat ever. Whatever.
Attention to all Raven Rock personnel.
Yeah.
This is your president speaking. I've invited our guest from Vault 101 to my office. Please do not impede his progress. Thank you for your cooperation.
Yeah, that doesn't last.
Keep it up, you're almost here.
That's not true. We're gonna get screwed over here momentarily. Okay, where am I going? Hey there, buddy. Think through here.
Attention. This is Colonel Autumn. You are hereby ordered to ignore the President's previous directive.
Yeah. Colonel Autumn's a douche. I look forward to killing him. Now, anyways, I'm going to do my best to not fight through this because we're going to get killed if I do. Of course, we're probably going to get killed anyways because, like, these guys. Yeah. They don't play at all. And this is basically the entirety of my playtime the last time I recorded this. For about 15 minutes before I got frustrated and rage quit. So hopefully, you know, maybe we'll be able to do a little bit better here. I'm gonna use some blood packs. We'll use a couple stim packs. I'm gonna pop a stealth boy and flip off my pit boy light. I apologize for blinding people. But I think that I bumped the brightness and contrast up. Whoa! Up enough that it shouldn't be a problem. Alright, where am I going? There's gotta be a door around here somewhere. Excuse me. Door. Oh god, Alan, right in the back. Yeah. Alright, well, at least I know where I'm going now. Oi. I don't even really know what Stealth Boys do. Cause, like, I could have sworn that they, like, made you invisible, but, you know, I'm still here. I don't know. Oh, that one had a ripper, I think. Yeah. I did get past this room last time, but, like, this is insanely difficult with the mods that I'm running. Like, it's just incredibly punishing, because they, like, know exactly where you are. So you can't be, like, sneaky. Oh god, it's the dude with the ripper, and I think I just threw a grenade at my feet. I have no idea what that was, but it was buggy and probably deafening to you poor viewers, I apologize. What do you have on you? Plasma grenades and a finger. Thanks. Crap. I pulled the grenades out at like the exact wrong time. I'm so thankful. Like, one thing I do like about the assault rifle is that it reloads so fast, actually. Like, I really don't want to have to like flip god mode on through this, but like, even with full health, these guys just, like, they waste me. Yeah, I'm gonna try and just be a wuss. Oh, my hit points. Where am I going? I don't know where I'm going. Oh, hey. Ooh. Whoa. Get out of my face. Not that way. This way. I'm a quick save. The dang, like, auto-run keeps getting toggled whenever I dash, it seems, and it just, like, screws me up. I have no idea what that was. Well, that's one. Okay. Alright, that's that group down. Eat all of my stim packs. I don't think I have anything else. Running pretty desperately low on ammo, and yes, I'm quick saving because I'm not a bitch. Alright, take that. Take the plasma grid. I do not care about that ripper. And the pulse rifle, I don't know. I might use this thing. There are two different weapons these guys have, and depending on which one this is, I might use it. Is this the little poof ball thing? Yep, that is not the one that I want. And I think it might be this. Little red laser? Yeah, this is the one that I'll actually be using, I think. Pulse rifle. Alright, just making sure, because I'm an idiot, and I'll end up picking up, like, you know, something of the same thing, and yeah. Oh, a little laser pistol. That's a thing. Alright, go ahead and quick save again. Ah, I'm regretting not investing in those energy weapon skills. Oh, I hear them, so we're going this way. So I guess I'm going down under. Oh. Can I? No. Oh, he's mad. Yeah, that's like, obvious trap is obvious. Can't tell if it's like an explosive or just an alarm. Let's find out. Oh! Okay, so it's like a little fuego trap. Good to know. Anything over here? I suppose I can flip my Pip-Boy light on now that, you know, doesn't matter. Alright, run! Aw, yeah, so we can just kinda dash through. Seriously, guys, leave me alone. Like, what the hell? They just murdered this scientist. I thought that they I didn't think they were allowed to do that. I thought that the Enclave was all about, you know, preserving technology, whereas the Brotherhood was preserving technology, but only for the Brotherhood. I don't remember what the ideologies were between. Did I kill him? I can't tell. I don't hear him anymore. Nope, there he is. Oh, are they coming down? Are they gonna? Yeah, they're coming down now. Oh, this is turning into a battle of accuracy, and when it comes to laser rifles, it's not what I'm gonna win. Where's my sniper rifle? There's my sniper rifle. You coward. Wait, what is it? X? Yeah, that's right. X is my sneaky button. I shot his gun out of his hands, totally intentionally. Alright, let's go back to shitty sniper here. Go ahead and quick save again. Like I said, in a battle range, like accuracy with energy weapons, Devon is pretty well unarmed. I'm gonna take that plasma rifle. I think I'm actually really close to, yeah, as I was saying, I'm pretty close to my weight limit. You know, play like that, huh? Right in the balls. Who needs a gun? Not you. Oh, he's got, no, he just picked it up, I think. Seriously, game. There, problem solved. Now that I have like next to no ammo left. Another plasma rifle. I'm actually gonna take that. I think that'll encumber us, but I want to repair. Oh, well, all right, screw that then. Go ahead and quick save again. You know, because, I mean, if I can loot while I'm here. Wait, seriously? MDMA in this thing? Like, wow. You Enclave guys aren't too on the straight and narrow, huh? Some T-55D power armor. T-55, T-45. Why you're talking? Like, I just want to get where I gotta go. I don't want to screw them. I am sorry, Anna Holt. I am sorry for unintentionally causing your death. Dirty water and a blood pack. And I'm gonna assume these are not all empty. Well, go ahead and loot. I didn't come this way on my initial run. I didn't really make it like too far on our last runs. We are already doing better. Which is why I'm quick saving all the time, because, you know, I'm just waiting for the other hand to drop. Alright. I don't know if I want to have my sniper out, but hey. Okay, so I gotta go this way. I want to find out what's this way, though. What's this way? That grammar. What's this way? Oof. Hey! Energy weapons! Arrival at peaceful resolutions by using superior firepower. Alright, your energy weapons has been increased by 5 as my chair squeaks in protest in the background. Apparently my chair does not want Devon to have energy weapons. This is like a brand new chair and it's already squeaking on me. I really gotta get like some WD-40 or something. Shut the thing up. The duct tape just does not work. Alright, pick the lock. Ugh. Zack's destruct sequence, huh? Well, that's curious. What is that?
I'm not entirely sure Eden can be trusted. And I think he knows I don't trust him. But I don't think he knows I have the emergency destruct sequence for his console. Priority override. Authorization code 420-03209. And boom. It'd have to be a last resort, of course, but at least the option is there.
Well, you know, if we meet up face to face with this Eden fellow, maybe, you know, maybe I can just nip that problem right in the bud. Alright. Oh, seriously, over-encumbered by freaking ammunition. Where's that buff out? We are, like, roid raging through this. Like, Devon doesn't even care anymore. He's, like, going all Brock Sampson on this place. Go ahead and quick save again. I don't like big rooms. Big rooms scare me. I don't even know what. Oh, it's a little map. I'm like, is it a teleporter? I don't think they have those. Alright. Alright, this is a loading screen, so quick save again. Man, I made it, you know, I made it across a whole room before I quick save. Fear me. Oh, shit! No, 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 no. Locked. Pick? Oh my god! Could you imagine, like, being one of those guys in that room, like, some asshole just comes running through, ninja picks the lock on the door and runs screeching forward? Oh. Oh, thank you, chair. Thank you. God dang, I gotta switch how I'm sitting on this thing. I don't need it, you know, making noise at me every time I move. Alright, 13 skill points. That's actually quite a bit. I'm gonna put into lockpick 3, and I think I'm gonna throw the other 10 all into medicine. I really want to shore up my medicine, so we're gonna continue. And let's see, level 12, so I think we'll have some new perks here, maybe? Yeah. Let's see, what do we got? Where are we starting? We're starting right here. Angry Drunk? No. Bear Grylls. So I drink pee? Eat any creature you kill, no matter how disgusting. While in sneak mode, you can devour creatures you have slain to regain health. Oh, that is, I think I might go with that. Cannibal. When you sneak, you can feed on a corpse to regain 25 health points, but every time you feed, you gain 2 radiation. You lose more karma than you would stealing, and if the act is witnesses, considered a crime against nature. Alright. 20% health bonus when using stim packs. Ooh. The fast metabolism, that's tempting. Although, you know, really, I try not to use them. I don't know. Never set off enemies' mines or floor. Wow, level 12 is a good level for perks here. Like, I want that one too. That doesn't really interest me. Oof, that's really nice. Ugh, like, I want all of these. I think I'm gonna go with Bear Grylls, though. I wanna know. It says eat any creature. I don't know if that means that I can eat people with this too. So we're gonna find out. I'm gonna go ahead and quick save. I mean, I suppose I could ambush somebody as they come through. I wonder if I can eat robots. Because that makes sense, you know. I don't know. Maybe I need a little bit more iron in my diet.
Face
to face. Okay, I didn't mean to do that, but...
It's high time we met. I'm quite pleased you were able to make it. The trip was not what I had intended, but serves as an adequate test of your abilities.
I'm gonna kill you. If we're meeting face to face, then show yourself. Don't hide behind a monitor.
Right here before you.
Devon's not a smart cookie. Well, then where are you? All I see is computers.
You should feel privileged. Colonel Autumn is the only other human permitted within this room. You are now privy to one of the few secrets our government now harbors. Do keep it to yourself, please.
Well, this explains why I've only heard your voice until now.
Very astute. Many people are content with a reassuring voice of authority, and never question the lack of public appearances. You, however, are not many people. You are unique. That is why I have asked you here. I think there are some things we should discuss.
I'm listening.
Our nation's capital is at a crossroads. The path that you and I choose here today will affect us all. I need you to act on my behalf to ensure that our country's future is secured.
What do you mean?
My abilities to influence the world are limited at this time. I alone can only do so much. You, however, may come and go as you please. You have a greater degree of freedom. Perhaps it's best if I explain why things need to change, and why I'd like you to act on my behalf.
I'll say whatever it is you have to say, then.
Our land is ravaged by mutation. The war was so many years ago, and yet we still suffer from its effects. We cannot move forward until humanity can gain a solid foothold in the world. To do so, we must rid ourselves of the mutations that have plagued us for so long. These super mutants, ghouls, hideous creatures. I believe your father's work can do that in a way unlike any other.
I'm not sure I like the sound of this.
You must understand.
We need to clear the way for humanity to rebuild the wastes. By making a few small modifications to the purifier your father worked on, mutations can be eradicated with a little effort. Anything mutated that comes into contact with that water will be eliminated, removed from the gene pool. Men and women of the world will no longer share it with the horrors and monstrosities that have become so commonplace.
That doesn't sound like something I'd know how to do.
What I require of you is really very simple. There is a vial in front of you filled with a modified FEV virus. It needs to be inserted into the control console for the purifier. Once that is done and the activation code is entered, the purifier will be activated and the process will be automated. It's not too much to ask of you, is it?
I'll give it some thought.
I understand. It's an unusual request, one I wouldn't make if it weren't of the utmost importance. Please understand that I cannot allow you to leave until you've taken the vial.
Hey, President, guess what? You're not even like a president. You're like Mecha Hitler here. You're going on like a eugenics program against ghouls. I bet some ghouls that aren't douchebags trying to eat my face off. Guess what?
Oh, come now. Bluffing is not really your style. Certainly no need to threaten me.
Yeah, the code's priority override authorization code 420-0320-9.
Oh my.
Yeah.
Root level access granted. Override 0923. Authorization J512. Self-destruct sequence initialized. Civilian is requested to secure FEV vial and vacate the facility at once.
Give me your vial. So am I just going out here then? Dick? Robo Dick? One for the road? Getting out of this frickin' enclave infested rat hole. Oh no. Oh no, of course it... I shouldn't have expected it to be... Oh, are they helping me? Oh, that Enclave soldier's spazzing out. Oh man, I've got the death bots on my side. That means I might actually survive. I'm gonna quick save because I'm a coward. Now what in the... Oh, that's weird when I go into, like... Weird. What's the SF on the right there? I don't know, it was there and now it's not. I don't know what that was. Hey! Oh my god! Did you see that? Those guys just got oh my god. I'm so easily entertained by this stuff. Mad Macho Tequila. I thought that said Mad Nacho. I'm not even gonna lie. I'm like, I could go for some nachos. I like nachos. Like, you know, in all honesty, yeah, that's right, you bastards. You better get out of here. In all honesty, like, I like cheese, but I'm not like a... My god, I love that I've got the death bots on my side. Like, I'm not a big cheese eater, generally speaking, but man, nacho cheese, ugh. Seriously? Since when did... Oh, fuck! I just realized what that door said! Why did I do that? I'm not a smart man. I just unleashed a death claw. Oh, man. I need to read before I do, I think. Man, this place is just going to hell. You guys should've... Protected your robo dick master a little better. Of course, they didn't know he was a robot. I'm gonna die anyways because, yeah. I'm gonna die anyways because I'm a freaking jackass. Like, let's charge ahead instead of letting the kill bots do their job. When did I last quick save? Okay, so that was right after Explodo occurred there. See, the game not letting me pick that death claw cage, that was the game warning me. That was a, hey you, don't be an idiot, and I'm like, you're not the boss of me. And I let a deathclaw go. So yeah, I'm just gonna leave that thing there, and we're gonna take this morphine, because we're actually addicted to it. We are still addicted. That's right, you guys are my little best... Oh my god. They're even cordial. I want these things that have, like, top hats or something. pip pip cherry ho, tally ho. I don't know. I'm not English. I don't know their. I don't know, it's like not even. It's not slang. I don't know what the term is for it. I don't know their. I don't know manner of speaking. I suppose. My God, why can I just not? Whoa, dude. Oh, okay, so that's good to know. I can actually drop these guys. Oh, they're running. They're running, you freaking jerks. Oh, God, they're coming back at me. Oh, God, there's, like, no cover. There we go. What are they doing? Like, I don't think I'm on a timer to get out of here. Like, not me personally. They probably... All right. All right, so I assume, yeah, that's... I don't know, I wonder if I can get in there. I don't know. I don't know if I want to try yet. I just want to shoot these dudes in the mouth. Oh God, why? Why did I immediately, like, I'm hitting the dash key right now and the game's like, no, you can run, but you can't. Ow, ow. I don't know. Apparently even with morphine in my system, you can't do the little quick jog with, you know, crippled feet. Damn it. Reloading. Jerks. You know, one of these days I'll hit the point in brain capacity where I'll save down there. That's right, Deathbots, you tell them. I wish I could have those things following me around always. Oh wow, you can actually look in there and see the horrible monstrosity awaiting your face. I do not like Deathclaws. They have always, like, creeped me out. Even, like, in the older games, they always, you know, were pretty intimidating. I'm so glad I found those self-destruct codes. Like, you know, that's what exploration gets you. That right there, you know. Hey, let's kill the president. Oh, and I'm on a list. Oh, and you're gonna get exploded. Wow, nice aim. BT dubs. Oh, I hit one. God, where am I? Why am I not running? Because the game said so. Yeah, you see in the bottom right corner, I've got SF. I don't know what that is. Oh, I think they killed all of my happy fun death bots. Oh, why? My limbs. My hit points. Oh. Jesus Christ. I don't even know. Did I save? Did I not save again? Seriously? I thought I did. But I didn't, because... You know, I bitch at myself for not saving, and then what do? I don't save. Logic. Well, I do have some ammo for my super shoddy. Not really enough to do anything, but I don't know, I might be able to drop a couple of them with it. Oh, hey there. Go on, guys, kill him. Kill him. What are you guys doing? Come on. Guys. Thanks. That grenade, I'm pretty sure that was totally necessary there. I need a beer on him that time. I like that their stuff's like randomized every time. That's probably exploitable in some fashion. There, I saved, even though we're like basically the end of the episode. But hey, oh, and he popped like a zit. I'm running for it because cowardice, holy shit. Well, hello there. Boxes of mines. Plasma cells, grenades, another stealth boy, because, you know, I guess. Please have stim packs. No, of course not. You've got blood packs, though, which, you know, I guess is just about as good. Oh, you jerk, you come down here, and you I am brutalizing your crotch with a shotgun, and it failed me. Oh my God, and we're just gonna load in. I'm probably gonna go a couple minutes over here, not too much. I'm not gonna make this like a 45 minute episode. I've been trying to keep these cut down to like roughly half an hour in length, just for sanity's sake and like render times and whatnot. I'm gonna use my blood packs. I don't know if I have any other. Oh, buff out. Buff out actually heals me. Oh yeah. Oh, it doesn't heal me. It just buffs my max hit points. Dang it. And I was hoping to go all like Super Saiyan on the... Like, you can't see it, but I'm just, like, throwing my hands up in the air, like, you know, what do? What do, internet? I got nothing. God, my reaction time is just not good enough to, like, I don't know, maybe what I should do is, like, when I inevitably get killed here again, do I have any healing here? No. Oh no, I got some Wanamingo meat. That'll heal me for 120 over a minute. Yeah, that's right, go for your kill, you jerk. What are you doing? Am I screwing your AI up here? You're up here. Am I screwing your AI up here?
Go.
Well, you don't have a grenade. Asshole. Like, the one thing I don't like about this is, like, the grenades, like, you see that did, like, next to nothing to him, but, like, if I hit myself with that, I'd be, like, in four pieces. Ah! Slow-mo right in the butt. That sounds terrible, but, you know, that's what happened. Alright, oh, nope, want that finger, I'm getting a collection going here, and this guy's limbs are all, you know, possessed by other people. Some bodies everywhere, hey, some Brahmin jerky, that's a little bit of health. Fingers, microfusion cells, a pulse mine, I am pleased with that. You know, it's better than nothing. I'm, like, slightly regretting not having any, what is that Brahmin jerky, there it is. I'm slightly regretting the lack of energy weapon skill. Whoa, hey there, frame rate. Oof. Curious how you disable those. Oh, come on! Oh, okay, I've got death bots. Less worried. Decidedly. I'm never gonna get tired of watching the death bots do their jobs. Like, they just mow these guys down. And I'm gonna get in there. Oh, I popped one of them, I think. Whoa, Enclave Heavy Gunner. Ow. Jerks. What is this? Power Armor Mark 1 and Mark 2, rather. Huh. How much does that weigh? Yeah, 100 pounds. I would take that because that's, like, really, really tanky frickin' armor. But I don't think I have room for it, sadly. By, like, a pretty high margin there. Come on, Deathbots. Do your Deathbotly duties. And make this jerk off with the gun die. That accuracy.
Neutralization operation complete.
Thank you, Deathbot. Enclave Devastator, because he had a missile launcher, I assume. And freaking awesome Tesla armor. Are we getting out? Yes, to the capital. Oh, God. I don't even want to know what it's going to be like out here. This is going to be bad, I am certain. If it is, I'm just going to turn around and go back in. And they can... Okay, I like that sound. Quick save. That's right, I made out, you cowards. Alright. Oh no. Oh, Fox! That's what I heard, you glorious son of a bitch. Glad to see you made it out of there, buddy. I like your gun.
Survived, and I had hoped to assist in your rescue to repay my debt to you.
Looks like you've got a new toy, huh, Fox?
Yes, and the most fascinating one at that. Oh, this technology is amazing. Imagine the evil that can be eliminated with such tools.
I can respect that. What are you doing out here?
I saw your capture. And a little cleverness allowed me to follow your captors. I only wish I could have arrived sooner to aid your escape. As I owe you my freedom, I felt it was only fair that I return the favor. After all, I know no one else in this world.
Like, why would I do that? Why would you be a dick? I guess, deal with it.
It seems I didn't know you. As well as I thought. My mistake. I read about a museum of history in the South. Perhaps I can learn more about the world there without facing such enmity. I will take my leave of you. Goodbye, my rescuer.
You know, I'm sorry that the game made me be an asshole to you there, Fox. Like, that's shitty, you know? I'm kind of butthurt. But, oh, that's right, you dicks. One of you didn't make it. I think I'm... Oh. That pleases me. Oh, that's right. You secondary explosions better be popping out there. Man, this place is just... You know, we're watching this. Yeah. Door. Wow, Devon is not impressed. You know what I think we gotta do right now? We gotta drink a Nuka-Cola Quantum. Tastes like cancer. Oof. Alright, I gotta know what happens if I run into the rotary blades. I gotta know. Dang it. Seriously, game, you're gonna disappoint me like that? Dang it! Like, that makes me so sad. That's one of my favorite things about Arma, actually, is that if you're not careful, you can, like, gib yourself in the rotary blades of helicopters. Anyways, you know, we made it out of there in one piece eventually. Yaogwai Cubs. Not anymore! Oh. No, you evil little bastard. My aim is terrible. Slow-mo. Oh, I didn't kill it. That one did, though. Since when do they have babies? I thought that they were supposed to be, like, sterile or something. Oh, is that Mama? No, that's just another couple. Alright, so they're just, like, reskinned. Ha! Resized. Oh, I hear Fox doing his job. There. Took them down. Because, you know, that's what I do. Alright, so we are going to save it and call it here. We're at, you know, 38 minutes. This is a pretty solid episode. I'm happy to be out of there. Look at it go. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching, and I will catch you all next time. We're in more Fallout 3. Until then.